Good morning, everyone. So today's class is about the discussion question of question and answers. Good morning. Good morning. In our previous class, we have completed our chapter number 8, right? And I have given you a homework to write the answers of NCERT's page number 98, right? How many of you have done that? How many of you have completed your homework? I want to know. I did very good, Vasundhara. Sampurna, very good. Okay, I know that all of you will absolutely do have done that. Okay, I don't get the science book. I have told you, Anurag, that please download the NCERTs from the CBSE website. Good morning, Raika. Okay. So, today we will be discussing about the answers of the questions. Okay. So, shall we begin? The first question is, indicate whether the following statements are true or false. The first one is, unicellular organisms have one-celled body. Is it true or false? Please give answer. Yes, Aniruddha, you can. Yes, it is true. I have got my answer, that is, it is true. We all know that unicellular organisms have only one cell in their body, right? The next one is, muscle cells are branched. Okay, Sampurna has given the answer. Yes, it is false. We all know that muscle cells are not branched. It is spindle-like shape, right? And now, can you tell me that which cells are branched in nature, in their shape? Which cells are branched? Nerve cells. Very good, Aditya. Yes, it is nerve cell. The next one is, the basic living unit of an organism is an organ. Is it true or false? Yes, it is false, right? Because we all know that the basic living unit of an organism is not an organ, it is a cell, right? The next one is, amoeba has irregular shape. Yes, it is true. We all know that amoeba is a unicellular organism and it has provided with only one cell in its body. And it is irregular in nature, right? In shape. So, we will be moving to the next question, that is question number 2. Make a sketch of the human nerve cell. What function do nerve cells perform? Now, for the sketching of the human nerve cell, the diagram has been provided in your NCERT book. It is in page number 92. Please practice the diagram from that portion, okay? And now, please let me know the answer of the second question. That is, what function do the nerve cell actually does? The nerve cell receives and transfers messages, thereby helping to control and coordinate the working of the different parts of the body. Exactly, very good, Sampurna. Yes, the nerve cells generally helps in the transmitting the impulse from one portion of the body to another. Okay, the next question. question is, write short notes on the following: cytoplasm and nucleus of a cell. Okay, so I know that all of you will be able to write the short notes of cytoplasm or nerve cells or nucleus, right? But I am telling you that not what to write, that is how to write. How to write an answer of a short note. Firstly, you have to make the note in certain points. You have to write in certain points and under some headings. The first heading you will give, that is the description. You have to give the first heading as the description. And under this heading, you will write certain points. That is how cytoplasm looks like, what are the cell organelles present, it is jelly-like in nature, the portions, that is all the points you will write under the description part. And the second point you will make, that is the function. And under this heading, you will write the function of the cytoplasm. Okay, is this clear? And another point, ma'am, am I correct? Functions of the nerve cells receives and transfers messages from body parts to brain and vice versa. Exactly, it also helps in controlling and coordination of the functions of the different parts of the body. Exactly, Shaptoshi, you are absolutely right. Very good. Okay, so is this clear to you, that how to write a short note? And another point, that is whether you have asked to draw a diagram or not, please do that. Please draw a diagram. In case of it is 2 marks question, please draw the diagram. Draw the basic diagram, like if it has been asked to cytoplasm, right? So you can make a diagram of a cell, point the cell membrane, then the nucleus, and then the cytoplasm, and give a heading, that is animal cell. Nucleus, we all know that there are only three basic components of the nuclear of a cell, that is the cell membrane, the cytoplasm and the nucleus, and apart from them the cell organelles are also present. Okay, the parts of the nucleus, first point you have written, that is cell membrane, it is a will be nuclear membrane. Okay, it will not be cell membrane, it is nuclear membrane. The different parts of the cell nucleus will be nuclear membrane, then the nucleoplasm, then the chromosomes, and after that it will be the nucleolus. Okay, exactly. So is this clear to how to write a short note? Okay, very good. Then the next question is, which part of the cell contains organelles? I know this is a very easy question. All of you will be able to answer this. Yes, it is cytoplasm, right? So within cytoplasm, we all know that within cytoplasm the cell organelles are present. The next question is, make sketches of animal and plant cells. For the diagram of animal and plant cells, it is provided in your NCERT books, page number 96. Page number 96, you will find the diagrams. and please practice the diagrams because they are very much important. Okay. Okay, Shomdatta, Saptarshi, you all are absolutely right. Okay, for the we have moved to the next question. That is question number 5. That is sketches of animal and plant cells. Please practice the diagrams of animal and plant cells because these all are absolutely the diagrams of biology are very much important because there are many diagram based questions in CBSE. Right. So the next question is state 3 differences between them. So for the difference part, you have to make 3 columns first. See how I have written the first column. In the first column, in any kind of difference like questions, you have to make 3 columns first. First, in the first column, you have to write the features upon which you are differentiating between the two. Right. The first one is the characteristics or the features. Now what are the and the second two and the next two columns are plant cell and animal cell. The first feature is the cell wall, the presence of the cell wall. In the cell wall and in the plant cell, the column of the plant cell I have written only present, and in case of animal cell I have written absent. The next point is blasted. In case of plant cell, it is present. In case of animal cell, it is absent. The next point is the size of the vacuole. In case of plant cell, it is larger. In case of animal cell, it is smaller. Right? You have to write the differentiating questions or in the questions where you have to write any difference. Please write the question in this manner. Okay? That will save your time in the in case of and your examinations. Okay, is this clear to you, ma'am? Am I correct? Vacuole is bigger in size, cell wall is present, animal cell subgenus is smaller in size. In size, cell wall is absent. Very good. Yes, you all are absolutely right. Okay. So the next question is, state the difference between eukaryotes and prokaryotes. So I have told you that in case of the differentiating questions, you have to write in this manner. So what will you write? In the first column, you will write that the true cell membrane. It is, we all know that in case of prokaryotes, they lack the cell membrane. And in case of eukaryotes, they are true to their shape of the cells, right? They have the proper nuclear cell, they have a proper cell membrane. And in case of the nuclear materials, in prokaryotes, they lack the certain nuclear membrane, nucleoplasm. They only have their chromosomes or genes. But in case of eukaryotes, they properly have a nuclear membrane and the nucleus is spherical in shape, right? Yes, Sampurna, you are absolutely right. But okay, Aniruddha, you are absolutely right. Yes, I can see that and a difference between you have provided the answer, that is animal difference between animal and plant cell, and it is, and you are absolutely correct. Okay, so shall we continue or move to the next question? That is, where are the chromosomes found in a cell? State their function. Where are the chromosomes found? Yes, it is found in the nucleus. And what is the function of the chromosomes? Chromosomes can carry genes. This helps in the transfer of characteristics from the parents to the offspring. This means that our parents pass some of their characteristics on to us. However, the different combination of genes from the parents results in different characteristics. Very good, Shampuna. Very good, Basundharam. You all are absolutely correct. I can see that I have to mention that you all are very much enthusiastically giving all the answers, and what is very good. This cooperation is needed, right? Because we all know that we are having a very difficult situation out there, but we have to coordinate, or we have to communicate through this only. Okay, so the next question is, cells are the basic structural units of living organisms. Explain. You all know that I have explained in my first class, that is why cells are known as the basic structural and functional unit. I know that you all are be able to answer this question, that is why cells are known as the basic structural unit of a body. Okay, I can see that three people are typing. Okay, so why the cells are known as the basic structural unit of the body? Because we all know that the structural unit, the cells are the basic units, because if we can divide the total organism into into the last portion, what we will get, that is the cells. The cells are the possesses all the features of the body, and they control all the functions of the body also. That's why in case of it is similar with a large wall made up of bricks. Because as if we break the wall, the last thing what we will get, that is the bricks, right? So that's why in the case is exactly similar in case of a higher order organism. The last thing what we will get is the cell. That's why the cells, a group of cells performing the same function is known as a tissue. The tissue, a group of tissue is known as the organ. The organ which are performing the same function is known as the organ system. And many organ systems forms a whole organism, right? This is the structural organization of a multicellular organism, right? We all know. So the basic structural unit is the cell. Sampurna, you are absolutely right. You have provided the right answer, the correct answer. And the last question is, explain why chloroplasts are found only in plant cells. Why it is found only in plant cells? Why we, in case of the mammals or in case of us primates, we all lack, in case of animals, we all lack the chloroplasts? Why this happens? Yes, the plants synthesis, we all know that chloroplasts are green in color, and chloroplasts also contains some chlorophylls within them, and which the chlorophylls are basically responsible for the performing the photosynthesis, right? And plants perform the photosynthesis, our animals are not able to perform the photosynthesis, right? And the last question is question number 10. That is, complete the crossword with the help of the clues given below. The across is, first one is, this is necessary for photosynthesis. What is question number 1? Yes, it is chlorophyll, right? Term for the second question number 3 across is, term for component present in the cytoplasm. What component is present in the cytoplasm? organelles, right? The living substance in the cell. Protoplasm is the living substance of the cell. We have discussed it in our class. And the 8 units of inheritance present on the chromosomes. What are the units of the inheritance? Genes, exactly, right? So we have completed the across portion and now the down. First one is green plastids. We have discussed just now, that is, the green plastids are known as chloroplasts. So the next one is formed by collection of tissues. Collection of tissues, we all know that a collection of tissues performing specific function is known as organ, right? And the fourth one is it separates the contents of the cell from the surrounding medium. Membrane, right? The cell membrane. Empty structure in the cytoplasm. What is the empty structure? Only the fluid filled or the cavity portion of the cytoplasm is known as vacuole, exactly. And the seventh one is a group of cells. A group of cell is known as tissue, right? Yes, exactly. So we have completed the question and answers portion, right? Did you enjoy it? Yes, yes, I have enjoyed it too. Okay, so in our next class we will be starting a new chapter. Or maybe there will be a surprise test for you. Okay. And I generally take a lot of tests. Okay. This is a prior warning to you all. Okay. Okay, please present for the as I will be taking your attendance. And until our next class, please be safe, be happy, and keep reading. Thank you.